Hey guys, it's Dave here from Creative Path Films, and today we're talking color temperature. So what is color temperature, and why is it so important in the photo video world? That's the question we'll be answering in today's video. And in fact, it's the first in a series of videos that we're gonna be doing on this topic. In the next video in the series, we'll be talking about the relationship between color temperature and your camera's white balance. So make sure that you're subscribed to the channel if you're not already, so that you don't miss that video when it goes live next week. I'll also leave a link to that video at the end of this one, as well as down in the description. All right, let's get into it. The color of light is measured in a temperature scale called the Kelvin scale, and it starts at absolute zero and goes up from there. As an object heats and its Kelvin temperature increases, it starts to give off more and more electromagnetic radiation. The lower Kelvin temperatures start off in the invisible infrared spectrum, but eventually they give off so much radiation that they begin to glow. And this is when an object moves into the visible light spectrum. Then it will move so high that it will pass into the invisible ultraviolet spectrum. We want to pay attention to those temperatures within the visible spectrum. Those at the lower end of the spectrum are closer to infrared, so they're warmer, redder tones. Then the temperatures at the higher end of the scale, they're closer to ultraviolet, so they're going to be more of a blue, cool tone. An easy way to visualize it is to think about heating a flame. Low temperature flames have a reddish orange kind of a glow, but as the flame gets hotter, it moves into like a neutral white color, and then eventually it will turn blue when it gets ultra hot. Different light sources will all sit at slightly different positions on the Kelvin scale, and therefore they'll give off a different color of light. Now let's go through some of the main ones that are relevant in the photo video world. Please note that these color temperature values are not always exact, and they can vary based on a number of different factors. A candle flame is a very low Kelvin temperature at about 1850 Kelvin, so it gives off a very warm reddish orange light. Moving up the scale a little bit is your incandescent filament globe. These sit at between 2400 and about 2800 degrees Kelvin, depending on the wattage of the globe. 2800 degrees Kelvin is also the approximate color temperature of the sun at sunrise and sunset. Next is our first primary color temperature, which is 3200 degrees Kelvin. And this is generated by tungsten halogen globes. Tungsten lights were and still are very much a staple in the photo video world. This means most cameras will have a 3200 degrees Kelvin preset already built in. Next up the scale is 4500 degrees Kelvin, which is the color temperature of most standard fluorescent globes that you'd find in an office block. In this example scale, we've set our camera's custom white balance to this color temperature, so it will appear to be neutral white. We'll be talking more about the relationship between white balance and Kelvin in the next video. Next is 5600 degrees Kelvin, and this is our second primary color temperature. 5600 degrees Kelvin, or daylight as it's commonly known, is the approximate color temperature of midday sun on a clear day. This is by far the most common color temperature, and many lighting fixtures such as LEDs, HMIs, and fluoros are designed at this color temperature. This is so they can be as versatile as possible because they match natural daylight. Next, we have 6500 degrees Kelvin, which is cooler again, and this approximates sunlight on an overcast day. This is also the most common color temperature used in computer monitors and televisions. Finally, we have 9500 degrees Kelvin, and now we're getting really blue. This color temperature is also within the range of many monitors and televisions, and is very close to the standard color temperature of Japanese televisions at 9300 degrees Kelvin. As you can see, it can be really useful to understand these different values. This way, you can match different lighting environments or recreate different light sources. Another important reason to remember these values is because they will determine how you set your camera's white balance so that your scene feels natural and organic. Being armed with this knowledge can help you in your lighting design by choosing the right fixtures to give you the look and feel that you're going to want. we're going to be talking about mood and emotion and how color temperature plays into that in a few weeks' time. So now's a great time to hit subscribe and hit that notification bell if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and let us know down in the comments, what did you think? That's all for now, but I look forward to seeing you again in the next video, which goes out every single Friday.